In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to fold this really cool diamond without tape or glue and no cutting. Ready, set, here goes. So for this model, I'm going to use a 6-inch square of Origami. Let's begin white side up and fold in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. And unfold and rotate and fold in half in this direction. Now this is a rather challenging model, so if you're new to folding, I wouldn't recommend folding this, but if you're up for the challenge, let's continue. Now fold this corner up so that it lands right on this point. And repeat on this side. And now open this pocket, put your finger inside, and squash it so that the crease lands on this edge. And completely unfold. And rotate so that these creases are nearest to you. And fold up so that these two points land on these two creases. But we're not gonna fold the whole thing. So just line up here and here, and just fold from this crease to this crease, just that middle segment there. And unfold, and now fold in half, and now we're gonna fold a square base. So fold this flap up, turn over and fold this flap up. Open the big pocket, stick your finger inside and push these two points together and flatten. So here we have the square base. Now rotate so that the open side is on top. And now fold this flap over and lift it up. And open the pocket, stick your finger inside, and squash it so that the crease lands on the middle line. Now fold this flap over, and lift this flap up, and open and squash it. Now turn over and bring this flap up and open and squash it. And fold over and lift this flap up and squash it. Now if you follow the sequence exact, then you should have a crease right there. But if you don't have the crease, then just find where that crease is by flipping the pages. And once you have the crease, and you have four flaps on this side and four flaps on this side, then fold the bottom behind on that crease. So it's like this. And now we're going to fold between these two points on all layers. When you do that, really try to go through this point on all layers. I know it's difficult because it's so many layers, but just do your best. Okay, and now unfold the flap and rotate. And now we're going to fold between these two points. And unfold. And now we're going to fold on this intersection so that these two points land on these two creases. And make that fold nice and sharp. Now completely unfold. And we have a pretty star. Turn over. And now we're going to fold on a lot of these creases. So starting right here. Now what we want is for the fold to actually originate right there at that point. So use the radial creases as guide marks. So I'm a little bit off, so I'm going to just adjust that fold and fold on the crease. It curves a little bit and it goes all the way across to this side. So it's like that. And now to make this fold really exact, place it on the table and make sure that you're going through those two points there and there. And this should be straight across, right in the middle. Okay, that's the first one. We need to do 7 more of those. So unfold this flap, rotate. So we folded there. Now we're going to start here and fold across here. But before you make it sharp, you want to make sure that you're actually going through this point, and I'm not. So adjust that fold, and that looks good. And pinch, pinch, pinch. Across here, slight curve, and end up there. That's number 2. And crease it sharply. Okay, so I think that you have the idea. There's 2, and unfold, and continue with number 3. We have to get to 8. And since I think you have the idea, I'm going to fast forward it from here. Now that we made all of the star folds, now we're going to make this octagon of creases. So start right here, right at the intersection. Pinch, pinch, pinch. Notice how my hand is behind to provide support. And pinch around. And make sure that those folds go through the actual intersection points. Okay, there's the octagon. Now let's do the inner octagon. And now turn over, and let's just try to erase the creases on the inner octagon. This is going to be the top of the diamond, so we just want a nice flat top. One more thing to do, these little folds right here should be mountain folds. So just pinch along those 8 little segments. Now turn back over, and we're ready to collapse. So let's start at a corner. And we're going to make this fold, and now fold this corner to here, like that. And we have this white flap here, and just try to make everything nice and flat around here. And now we're going to make this fold, and fold this corner to here. Notice how my hand is inside. Let's see what it looks like inside. So it's like that. And now we're going to do number 3. So now make this fold and fold this corner to here. And number 4. Like that. So now it looks like a glove. Put your hand inside and just try to flatten these so that they look really nice. And you can also just make this look good. Since you actually have access, you can stick your fingers inside. This is the best time to get out any little glitches. Okay, so Those are four. Now, holding here, undo these folds. And now, continue on this side, and we're going to do four on this side. So, make the fold, one. Make this fold, two. Three. And four. And we have another glove. And now, stick your fingers inside to provide support. And make it look nice. Okay, so that looks nice on this side. And now we're going to continue 5, 6, 7, 8. We've already done it, so hopefully it'll be easier just to remake those folds. So start with this one, number 5. And 6. I think we have to take our hand out at this point. So that's 6. 7 and 8. Just fold this flap over like this and turn over and make this fold. So it's like this. We end up with a white flap inside of this flap. And looking inside, we want this white flap to go into that pocket. So first, put your finger in and just kind of make a hole for it to go. And now take this flap and stick it into the pocket. Like that, and close it back up. So we have this one flap left, and we're going to do a reverse fold. And this is pretty challenging. So make it go back and forth, just loosen up that fold. And now open right here, not too much. We don't want the whole thing to open. Just separate 4 flaps on this side and 4 flaps on this side. So here's the pocket. Put your finger inside that pocket. So this is where the reverse fold is going to go. And now we're going to stick it inside by just pushing it into that pocket. So you want it to be a valley fold right here. And make sure that it's going into the pocket. And when it's inside, just close it up like that. So hopefully you were able to do that. That's the most challenging part. And once it's like that, then you just want to fix up the folds. You might have to pull on points. Like this looks kind of open. So I'm going to pull these apart and try to make that as a mountain fold so that it sticks up and closes that. So I cleaned that one up, but I messed this one up. And so this is a delicate little dance of trying to pop up points. Like that. And I'm first trying to get this to look nice. So it's all mountain folds. Get out any little glitches. And then we'll work on the crown up here. So that looks pretty good. And now turn over and now, just push on different points to try to get the little glitches out. There, that looks pretty good. A little delicate dance. And there it is, oops, one more little glitch. And there's the completed diamond. So this is a really challenging model, but I hope you were able to fold it. And I don't know what else to say, except that it's pretty cool looking, and it doesn't do much except look cool, and I guess it can make for a very nice gift. So, all right, hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I'll see you guys later. Bye bye. And here I managed to fold it out of a pearly plastic paper. It was really difficult, but it looks pretty cool. All right, bye guys.